So today we'll be talking about the central message of Chaitanya Shikshashtakam. Now we have been talking about the structure of Chaitanya Shikshashtakam, the function, and also why Chaitanya Shikshashtakam is very important to Gaudiya Vaishnavism. Now going further, we'll today focus on what is the focus of Chaitanya Shikshashtakam, the central focus or the message of Chaitanya Shikshashtakam. Okay, Chaitanya Shikshashtakam, if you want to answer this question, you have to see Chaitanya Shikshashtakam from a very different perspective. Chaitanya Shikshashtakam can be looked upon from the perspective of holy names, because the entire Chaitanya Shikshashtakam is talking about chanting of the holy names of Krishna. Like for example, the first and the second verse is talking about glories of holy name. The third verse is talking about Trinadapi Sunichena, the quality of chanting holy names. The fourth and the fifth verse is talking about the prayers to do while chanting the holy names, and also the mood. And the 6th, 7th, 8th verse is talking about the advanced moods in chanting of the holy names. So this is from the perspective of chanting of the holy names, Chaitanya Shikshashtakam. But Chaitanya Shikshashtakam can also be looked upon from the perspective of service. Now although Chaitanya Shikshashtakam is talking about chanting of holy names, and although Chaitanya Shikshashtakam is talking about love of God, for example, 6th, 7th, 8th verse are talking about the result of chanting of holy names, that's love of God. Or the first verse again is talking about various gifts of chanting of holy names, and one of the gift is love of God. Sarvatmana snapanam param vijate Shri Krishna sankirtanam. Sarvatmana snapanam here is referring to love of God. So Chaitanya Shikshashtakam is talking about chanting of holy names and love of God, but it can also be looked upon from the perspective of service, because Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he says, all the verses of Chaitanya Shikshashtakam are pointing to Abhidhaya. Abhidhaya means the process, and the process is service to the Absolute Truth. In fact, the last verse, Ashlishyava Padratam Penastu Mama Darshanam Marmatam Kurotuva Vitatathava Vidhatulam Pato Mat Prana Nathastu Seva Napara. Nath. The concept of Nath is there. Oh my Lord, you are my master and I am your servant in any condition. So if you want to look Chaitanya Shikshashtakam from the perspective of service, the first and the second and the third verse are talking about the best service which can be rendered to Shri Krishna is chanting of holy names. So of course, these three verses are talking about holy names, chanting. But now we are going a little deeper. We are trying to understand why chanting of holy names is so dear to Krishna, because that's the best service to Krishna. And how do we know that? Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela, third chapter, it is said, Bhajner Madhya Shreshna Vidha Bhakti Krishna Krishna Prem Dite Dhare Mahashakti Tar Madhya Shreshna Nam Sankirtan Nirapradha Nam Laila Paya Prem Dhan. So of all the processes of devotional service, the Navvida Bhakti, the nine-limbed devotion, that's the most important. And of all the nine-limbed devotion, of all the nine processes of devotion which are important, out of all of them, chanting of holy names is the best form of service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, which can, if name is chanted offenselessly, it will give love of God. That is the opinion of Chaitanya Charitamrita. So that's about first three verse. The fourth and the fifth verse are the prayers while doing service of Supreme Personality of Godhead. When we are doing service, what prayers we should offer, that is the fourth and the fifth verse. And the best prayer while doing service is Oh my Lord, please engage me in your service. I'm doing your service, but I want to do more service to you. That is the fourth verse. Mama Janmani Janmaneshware Bhaktad Bhakti Rahitu Kitvai. And the fifth verse is, accept me as your servant. And don't reject me from your service. Don't neglect me from your service. Now that's the fourth and fifth. And the sixth and the seventh and the eighth verse is asking Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, or a devotee is asking Supreme Lord Krishna a gift by which they can increase the intensity of service of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, and that is love of God. The prayer is yugaitam nimishena ashlishe vapatratam enam gada shrudharaya vadnam gada darudhyagira ulkaya nichitam vapugada tavanam agrahane bhavishyati. When will that day come when there will be tears in my eyes? In other words, when will that day come when I will possess love of God? Now why there is a prayer to ask, why they are asking love of God? Not for sense enjoyment, but to increase the intensity of service to Krishna. Because without love, no one can serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead 24 hours or 25 hours. It's impossible. So that's why we need love. Why? To serve Him, to increase the intensity of service. Tivrena bhakti yogena cheta purusham param. So this then, service is then the central message of Chaitanya Shikshashtakam. Chanting of holy names is also the message of Shikshashtakam. Love of God is also the message of Shikshashtakam, but the base message of Shikshashtakam is service to Supreme Personality of Godhead, because chanting of holy names is the best form of service, and love of God will increase the intensity of service. So we have to keep this in mind when we are reading Chaitanya Shikshashtakam. In fact, these fourth and fifth verse, the prayers while chanting the holy names. The fourth verse is, they are praying for the service of God. Mama Janmane Janmaneshware Bhaktad Bhaktirahitu Kitvai. And the fifth verse is specifically praying for the person who is being served. That is Krishna. Please make me a speck of dust at your lotus feet. Sthita Dhuli Sadrisham Vichinte. So you see, the concept of service and served, and the servant, that's the concept rotating in Srimad, in Chaitanya Shikshashtakam. In fact, the 6th, 7th and 8th verse, where they're asking for love of God, the devotees, to increase the intensity of service, it is said, initially service is done with respect. And when devotees advance, then the service is done with love of God. When the service is done with respect, it is not so intense. But when it is done with love, it is deep and very pleasing to Krishna. And very intense. That is why Rupa Goswami uses the word Sandran Atma Visheshatma. Sandran Visheshatma. The emotions and love of God is very deep and very condensed and very pleasing to God. And that's why it is said, initially, a devotee should always focus on mercy of God. Mercy. The mercy, of all qualities, we should focus on mercy. And when we advance, of all qualities, we should focus on love of Shri Krishna. And that's how this Chaitanya Shikshashtakam is graded. That's the fourth and fifth verse. Is talking, the devotee is focusing on the mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. I Nanda Tanuja Kinkaram. The word I contains this sense of mercy. And then Yugaitam Nimishena Ashlisheva Padratam Panishtumam. That is love. So that's what Chaitanya Shikshashtakam. But everything, mercy and love, everything is for what? Is for doing service to Supreme, is to render service to Supreme Personality of Godhead. So that we should keep in mind. The central message of Shikshashtakam, which is service to Shri Krishna. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.